Today we're getting donuts.
I hope I get some holes.
Right.
Welcome to Date Night Is Sacrosanct. I'm Ryan Burton, and with me as always is Wendy, ugliest tie in the universe, Fisher.
Oh, wow, you're so mean.
I am.
And it is Date Night Is Sacrosanct.
Coming to you live from the place where we tape Date Night Is Sacrosanct.
It's not live at all. You're going to watch this so much later.
Thank God for that.
Oh my goodness. So the premise of the show is that I ask him, the infallible, never wrong Ryan Burton, three questions.
Yeah.
And we're going to take about 10 minutes to run through the three questions.
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready for your first question?
I can be.
All right. How is
Hold on, wait for it. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm now ready.
Are you warmed up?
Now I'm primed.
Are you pumped?
I'm primed.
Are you hype?
No. You don't want me hype.
Alright. How is conflict resolved among competing running stags?
It's running stags? Running? R-U-T-T-I-N-G?
Double T.
I want to make sure I have the correct stags.
Yes. Like deer.
Not competing beer parties at a college frat house. Not like guys who are going to prom but without a date because they couldn't manage to successfully get a member of any sex to go with them. Or to a wedding. Okay, so not those stags.
Not those stags.
Although I have a number of fascinating, interesting anecdotes on those stags. Okay, let's see. So running stags.
Competing.
So first, they both entered the same competition, which is usually an eating competition. So they wind up going into like the Nathan's Famous Hot Dog competition, or they wind up getting into, there was this one time they wound up doing a it was the biathlon, the one that's just cross-country skiing and shooting.
That's a thing?
Yeah, that's absolutely a thing.
Oh.
Winter Olympics. People get gold medals in it. It's kind of nuts.
Is this true?
Yeah, like, all you do is you cross-country ski and you shoot a gun at a target. And then you cross-country ski some more, and then you shoot into a target. And then you cross-country ski some more, and you shoot into your final target. And it's based on your time and accuracy.
And competing running stags do this.
Competing running stags have been known to do this, yes.
Okay.
And now, what's weird is they don't compete for the same reason that you or I would compete. They don't compete for your selfish desire for glory or my ridiculous idea that I'm the greatest of all time and should never be besmirched in any way, shape, or form. No, they do it for a Philly cheesesteak.
Worthy. So they're just lusting for
this? They're just lusting for this cheesesteak because, let's be honest, cheesesteaks are amazing, guys.
Oh,
if you haven't had a cheesesteak, you are not helping yourself at all.
Those onions.
No, why would you say that? Why do you hate me?
He's allergic to onions. He is. Alright, are you ready for the second question?
Guess. Now you got me all mad about onions.
A little itchy?
Shut up.
Okay. please describe the history of Scotland from ancient times until today.
Scotland was founded by a unicorn.
A cousin of the stag?
Well, really distant cousin.
Okay.
That is why the unicorn is the official animal of Scotland. That's a fact. So, a unicorn founded Scotland under the pretense of two very important factors. One, potatoes are great, yo. Seriously, they're really cool. Don't make that offended face. Potatoes are cool. Fries are great.
Scotland is not where the potato famine happened.
You're right. Because potatoes are cool. Why don't you bring up Ireland? That's weird.
Oh, God. Okay.
So, one, yes. Potatoes are cool. Right?
Okay.
Wow, you're reading way too much into this. One, potatoes are cool.
Okay.
Two, skirts are the new pants. Over time, that evolved into kilts. it was steeped in tradition. So that's why there are many different coats of arms on their tartans, depending on what kind of design they have, which plaids, which colors, which thicknesses. I would go into which one specifically.
The Burton clan?
No.
Are you Scottish?
Allegedly.
Okay.
I just don't know which of the clans my family hails from.
Okay.
That family has been lost to time.
My family is the Macaulay clan, and our clan motto is danger is sweet, or in danger sweetness, but in Latin, which I don't know.
I'm pretty sure that your danger is, or your family motto is, don't leave Kevin home alone.
Oh, Kevin, yeah.
He's gonna burn the fucking house down if we leave him alone. Or bandits will certainly die by his hand.
Wow, those movies were amazing when I was 10.
Yeah.
Amazing.
And I gotta tell you, a lot more slapsticky than they deserved. Because if you come into my house, I will call down the thunder.
Yeah?
Yeah, I will burn this house to the fucking ground before you take a single thing out of it.
We'll talk about that.
I will burn it all to the ground.
So when
I will pee-pee on the ashes.
Are you ready for your third question?
I guess.
What are three ways in which one might...
Pee-pee on the ashes.
Learn another language.
Yeah, buy a tour book for another country and pee-pee on the ashes. Learn through osmosis.
Of their culture.
Of their heritage, their economy, their...
Defense system.
Yeah.
Immune system.
That's how you learn what their launch codes are, is you burn their books down and you pee on the ashes.
America.
Fuck yeah. So basically, just go to one of their libraries.
Swear counter.
No. You want a swear counter for this episode?
I do.
We're up to one. That's very boring.
Okay. I rely on you.
All right, because I'm not going to put it in for only one. Yeah, that means if you guys want to post a question where I have to be swear-laden, then a swear counter will be, like, right here.
And don't you dare say fuck that, because that would make you sad.
Now you're at one.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the weirdest game of swear tennis ever.
Shit. I'm swearing.
So, to learn a language, go to one of their libraries in the country of your choice, burn it to the ground, pee on the ashes, number one. Number two, be born somewhere else. If you want to learn another language, it makes it easier to learn a language than total immersion and not having any idea how to speak a first language. Yeah? Do you want to learn Spanish? Be born in Spain. Right? Sounds good.
I'm gonna
ask. Cool. That sounds like a neat language to learn. I guess. You wanna learn Russian?
Yeah.
Be born in Russia.
Ooh, no.
No. That is because you do not have civic pride. Now, third way, if you can't be born somewhere and you're
Russia. In Russia there is no language. There is only potato. It's not potato, it's rock.
Scotland has rock?
No, Russia. Russia has only rock, no potato.
Oh, that's... Now you're getting political. That's very sad.
That is a little political.
That's rude.
Apologies to Russia, I do love you.
Yeah.
But not too much. Not in a way that would make my countrymen weird.
She's lost it. Alright, so the third way is to kidnap a tutor who happens to teach that language and just chain them up to a radiator in your basement. And over the next couple of weeks, just really get as much information out of them.
You'll come out and you'll be saying things like, I am fucked my vassal in Russian. Hello. Like
5 and 6.
Can you direct me to the jeep balls?
Can you direct me to the what?
if you kidnap somebody and force them to teach you their language, then you're not going to come out speaking very well. I would Pimsleur everything they say. We are not sponsored, by the way, by Pimsleur, and they are glad about that.
I guess? What the hell is a Pimsleur?
It's a brand name approach to learning.
To language. Learning?
To learning language.
What is this web series for? I'm teaching you everything you need to know about the world. All the time. With ultimate perfection. Jeez.
Everything else is a competitor.
This is a documentary, and I'm doing it for free. With my benevolence. It's important for you to know.
That you are sleeping on the couch tonight because you're an ass.
What?
Yeah.
Like seven. You're up to seven swears. No.
With the counter.
We're up to like 14.
The counter was his idea. Goodbye. I